Hi everyone, Mark Aboy with you again, out in the woods, off-grid. First of all, I'd like to give a shout out to all of you, my loyal subscribers. I truly appreciate all of you signing on and watching the videos on my channel. I love to hear from you all and do my best to answer all your queries, so keep them coming, and thanks again for subscribing. Recently, I posted a video describing my ad hoc solar setup at the cabin, assembled on the cheap, over time. Despite piecemeal assembly and a little trial and error, I managed to keep things simple and manageable. In short, it fits my modest needs of lighting and a little 110 AC via an inverter from time to time. A few years ago, Planeaboy and I built this workshop using a chainsaw mill and a Honda generator for power. Despite my lofty design, including a clerestory for added light, I found the interior a little dark, especially in the winter. With this installation I'm starting today, my goal is to install these panels to charge batteries which will supply 12 volt power for interior lighting, so I don't have to run the generator. I may install a 1500 watt inverter at some stage to run small power tools, but that's down the road. In the meantime, all the tools in the shop run on batteries or via the generator, which is always at the heart of most solar systems. Anyway, today my plan is to install the panels on the roof. Step one, so let's get started. The panels I'm about to install are rated at 85 watts each for a combined total of 255 watts. Now, as one of my viewers has pointed out, this stuff is often overrated, so I will fall short of the advertised rating. However, based on experience, I know the three of them will keep my batteries charged to the extent that I need, summer and winter. I'm happy to say that the panels did not cost me anything out of pocket. I got them with points on my credit card. They arrived with an array of mounting hardware, including lots of wire, rubber grommets, and stainless nuts, bolts, and roofing screws, all of which will be very useful, of course. First, I have to check whether the panels will fit, as it were, my metal roofing profile, and so far, it looks good. Next, I have to modify the fancy stainless hardware provided, which can be difficult, as stainless steel is notoriously tough. However, nothing like a firm vise and a big hammer. Making this stuff from scratch would be quite nitpicky and time-consuming. Once the hardware is attached to the panels, it's time to ascend the roof and screw them down. The roof sheathing is a solid deck of 2-inch Douglas fir, so there's no problem locating a good hold. In this case, the combination of rubber grommets and washered stainless roofing screws provides a very tidy and secure waterproof attachment. This section of roof is south-facing and serves to present the best face to the sun. Trees may shroud this area in winter when the sun is low and there won't be a lot of bright daylight. But this is my best compromise, short of felling a bunch of healthy trees. I can always add more panels if necessary. Now the panels are securely installed, I would like to route the wires as economically and as hidden as possible. What I've decided to do is solder the individual panel leads to a number 6 gauge wire that will take the juice from the panels to the charge controller. Low voltage doesn't travel long distances along narrower gauge wire without some loss, so this will tidily enhance transmission somewhat via the 6 gauge wire I happen to have to hand. The wires that travel over the roof are protected with a half-round ABS pipe, which also serves to shroud the hole through the roof. In addition to the large eave overhang, this should provide decent cover. The 6-gauge wire will eventually mate with the charge controller I have yet to install, along with the batteries which will sit up high on this beam. In part 2 of this install, I will hook up the charge controller and batteries.
Now before we go, we'll just see if we're generating power where we need it, ready to hook up the charge controller. And it's the top 3 buttons here that we're looking at to light up. Now considering the sun has gone around behind the trees now, it's later in the afternoon, I'm not expecting a strong signal. There we go, it's showing 14.5 volts or above, which is plenty to charge the batteries that we need.
In the meantime, thanks for watching once again, and if you are not already a subscriber, please click on the link at the end of the video and take a look around my channel. Questions and comments always welcome. See you next time.